Yo, what's good everyone? In this video, I'm gonna show you 100 tips and tricks that are gonna turn you into a demigod. These are 100 of the best tips that I can come up with that are gonna help a mix of all players. Whether you are new or have been playing this game for a while, there's gonna be tips in here that you haven't heard before, or there's gonna be tips that you probably forgot about. There's literally only one video about this topic on all of YouTube, and today, we're gonna change that. As of right now, the thing that separates me from this video is that the previous video has 10 million views and this one has zero. If I miss anything in this video, leave a comment so I can heart it for others to see. Share your tips down below and let's pop off. If this seems quick, that's because it is. Use code KEMBEANS at checkout. I bet any amount of money I'm catching at least one of you with this tip. Make sure you're boxing up correctly. If you don't want a cone in your box, it goes wall, floor, cone, and then walls around you. This prevents yourself from placing cones and walls above you. Pros do this. If someone's trying to phase into your box, instead of holding the wall, you could pre-fire the second the wall breaks to get an unexpected shot on them, and then try building right away after that. Never die with a lot of mats. If you're weak, overbuild a little if you could afford it. You do that for two reasons. Not only do you grief the other person by not giving them your mats, but you're also giving yourself the best fighting chance because you're using everything you got. Box fight with a cone in your box. Stairs are good too, but for the most part, cones are more effective. Only Mongraal classic when you catch a player off guard. The general rule of thumb is to place a cone in someone's box if he's looking at you. Face King is really good at doing this. If you plan on W keying games, I would recommend not landing at the hottest place on the map like Salty. Land more at a less populated area with only a few teams going there. You're gonna end up being less tilted because you have better odds of killing 4 to 5 people compared to the 10 kids that might land at Salty. Unless you're the last third party out of everyone, you're more than likely gonna die. If you're in a fight, be the one who pushes instead of the one who boxes up. Putting constant pressure on others will put you in control and not them. Practice all the ways to exploit into someone's boxes using shockwaves and other items in the game. The more exploits you know, the more well-rounded you're gonna be. You don't need to know high ground retakes for optimal realistic fighting. Learn high walls, trifo cones, protected, and elevated side jumps. The reason you learn high ground retakes are to get more familiar with the building grid in Fortnite. If you don't feel like VOD reviewing, which most people don't, write down your mistakes somewhere so you know what you can improve at. If you're one that gets extremely tilted, go in creative and crank for a little. Take a break and do something more relaxing. Doing small things like this really helps. Practice everything with right hand peeks. Learn more than just peanut butter edits. Peanut butter edits are the top corner edits that people make. They only do this for right hand peeks. Do not spam your crouch button mad fast. It's not like editing where the faster you press the better. Optimal crouch peeking is timing it correctly so that it's smooth and consistent. Going too fast could screw it up. If you want to be completely silent while creeping up to someone, you need to crouch while aiming, not just crouch. If you are a controller player, PC or not, and you don't want to spend hundreds on a scuff or paddled controller, teach yourself how to play claw. I have multiple claw guides and tips and tricks on my YouTube channel. Some of my most viewed videos as well, so check them out if you're learning claw. Double check to make sure you're using the toggle harvesting tool bind instead of the original. This makes it so when you double click it, it switches to the previous weapon you had out. Learn how to side jump out of boxes when getting pressured. This helps you gain height, get out of a bad position, and make it harder for the enemy to track you. When you're in a rush and accidentally pick up a gun in the wrong slot, get used to pressing the button that your shotgun is not usually in, so you're not rearranging mid-fight. To rearrange your inventory, just make sure you're in the clear and you're safe. A good tip to help the previous one is to have hold to swap turned on, so it swaps out the gun you're holding for the one you want on the floor. Storm surge and when it activates. Listen up, if you are below the damage threshold, it does 25 damage to you starting with shield every 5 seconds. There's 9 zone phases in Fortnite. The warnings happen the zone before. In the second zone, there's a warning. When the third zone opens, it starts killing. There's only 70 players allowed. In the fourth zone, there's a warning. And when the fifth zone opens, it starts killing people. There's only 50 players allowed in the fifth zone. Sixth zone is a warning for the rest of all the zones. There's only 30 players allowed from zones 7 to 9. The second those zones open, it's gonna start killing. If at any time there are more players than allowed, the storm surge will not go away until the lobby is at the required amount. And also, guess what? Storm surge is also in pubs and arena, but it never gets triggered no more because everyone W keys. Re-listen if you're confused because that's a lot to take in, but I assure you, it's correct. If someone's pushing a box, good practice to go for a shot and then peace control because more than likely they're gonna try and run away. If you have consistent shaky aim when someone's inside your box, lower your freaking sense. That's probably the biggest indicator your sense is too high. Also, to not be shaky, act like it's a creative fight. It's a mental game as well. If you're a controller player with no paddles, you should force yourself to get used to R3 as jump. This gives you the most optimal jump binds in the game, allowing you to jump and turn while shooting. Nothing beats claw though. Simple tip, but always put your heals or consumables to the right on your inventory slot when you're on keyboard. When you're on controller, you want your shotgun in the first slot and then put your SMG in the second slot and then the AR in the last slot. Heals in the middle. Right here, I'm going to show you a few simple high ground retakes that you can learn. There's millions, but here are a few that even I do. Don't take build fights in games if you can help it. Box fighting is meta. Have good crosshair placement when building and peace controlling people. Keep your shoddy at head level all the time if you can help it. Pros do this without even thinking about it. Not only do you keep your shoddy head level when you're running around, but whenever you complete an edit, you want to be head level as well. Whenever you're about to confirm an edit, crouch as you're confirming it, so when you confirm it, you're set up for a right hand peek. Learn to make your edits smooth and consistent before you make them fast. When you and your team are in the same box together, the goal is to get someone to drop onto your box and get them full box for a free kill. Doing this correctly results in a refresh every single time. When you're trying to piece control someone, always have an escape route, so if all else fails and it backfires on you, you're not cornered in your own box. Camp on rocks during scrims if possible to use as rotates. Literally takes zero skill and works beautifully. Keep your inventory in the same order, plain and simple. Pre-fire with your shotgun and then build a roof when someone is spraying above you. It's the best way to get them to lay off your box. Learn how important high walls are. They're meta if you don't know already. Definitely go out of your way to learn these if you haven't. Whenever someone is hard pushing you, build a 2x1. It's kind of like big dick energy. Take up more space for a better chance to win. An early game fighting tip is to learn how to use natural cover more at the start since you don't have a lot of mats to begin with. Early game tip, when you're looting in the start of a game, always smack small pieces of furniture as you're running or jumping by so you keep momentum and loot faster. When you VOD review, watch from your opponent's perspective so you can gain a better idea of how to be protected when playing. Analyze the times that you left yourself exposed. After a beam, when someone boxes up to heal, spray the minimum number of bullets before reloading for continuous pressure to prevent the opponent from healing to buy time to get to their wall. Turn on auto open doors if you haven't already, plain and simple. If you get hit hard, build away and in multiple boxes. Try to put a lot of builds between you and your opponent. Pros do this all the time. You can break the rocks with builds instead of pickaxing them. Saves you time and helps you not to get sniped. Watch pro streamers play so you can start copying things they do. Chem beans. If you watch them a lot, you will slowly start to implement what they do into your game. Cursor mode is like a toggle inventory on release. I use this bind and I find it helps me in game. Don't spam jump when you're running in the open. Your movement is way more predictable. The better way is to strafe right and left while moving forward. It's way harder to predict. The meta this season, for people who don't know, dragon shoddy with tack if you have nothing else to hold. Or you can run either attack or a charge with an AR. Or you could just run a dragon shoddy, but it's very risky and you can't 2v1 effectively with it. Also, if you miss your first shot, you're kind of screwed. Edit with your blueprints out as much as possible. Simply put, it allows you to edit from further away. Never blatantly build fight. It's better to spend less mats on low ground while you track your opponent. Info like this is more important than height. W keying in arena is a smart way to get better. Learning from your mistakes when you die is something every pro preaches, including clicks. Don't compare progress to others. Remember, 90% of all the 1 week progression videos are completely fake. Believe nothing of what you hear and only half of what you see. That's what my dad told me. Don't always look to shockwave into someone box head on. Do it from a box diagonal from them so they can't see you. Throwing it diagonally to get into their box is mega important to catch them off guard. If you're ever in a box with someone under your ramp holding their shoddy out, edit out one of the sides and then edit the ramp for a nice peek shot. This is still meta and works a lot because not a lot of pros do this. Pull out your pickaxe and weapon really fast so you could bait the player to edit. Sometimes just shooting twice with an AR and switching back to your shotgun works too. Then you could get a shot off and build to block a shot. Trying to get the cleanest double edits possible, all you really need to do is focus on doing the smallest movement possible. I've been doing this in creative for about a week straight now, and because of it, I'm able to track enemies way better. When you're going full peace control Kyle on kids, don't take out your shoddy until all the peace control is finished. If you're ever in a position where the other player is more than halfway behind this floor, shove a stair in their box and then full box them just from the window. Matter of fact, next tip, always try to peace control from a window. Even Mongraal classics are way safer this way. It's a safe place that allows you to get a crouch peek in. Try to play on different server regions every now and then. This forces you to change your playstyle and force you to learn the game in a different form. Learning every area of the game makes you stronger and more well-rounded. The best way to practice Mongraal classics is this Mongraal tarp I started doing in creative. Literally just run around in circles, placing walls and stairs. It feels so good when you can actually do it fast. If you're running up to a player's box, Mongraal classic in front of the wall you want to take, then quickly shoot your AR to replace the wall. This is one of the safest and quickest ways to do it. Practice protected Mongraal classics. This is starting to become more popular, but it's not fully meta yet. It's gonna be though. Build out of hard mats in fights. So many people are stingy with their hard mats. Stop doing that. This is a major tip that gives you an advantage. It discourages people to not hack at your walls as much, and 9 times out of 10, most people build out of wood. So you'll more than likely get your mats back. Build with wood when you're rotating in the open and climbing mountains. Make sure you learn how to do all your mechanics from both sides and not just one. A good example of this is the Thwifo cone. Depending on where the opponent is, you need to build the walls on the right side so you don't get shot at. If you ever get bored, learn more ways to free build. There's endless amounts of free building retakes. These helps with warm-ups and learning more of the building grid. Even though I want you to use my code, you don't need a pro skin in the item shot to be good. Just try and use any skinny skin you have with a pickaxe that doesn't sound annoying. Don't overthink it. When you warm up your aiming, don't tense up. Have a firm grip on the keys and your mouse. Or if you're a controller player, play in a relaxed position. Pretty much just have a good posture. Huge duo tip. Just remember, if the duo doesn't work in a few weeks and you feel like the chem isn't there, then it's probably not meant to be. Lots of people are scared to admit this because they don't have anyone else to play with, so they think they're forced to play with the duo they have. Focus more on your movement when you tunnel. Notice how when you do this tunnel right here, especially on keyboard and mouse, you constantly have to readjust yourself to make sure you don't hug the wall. When you start out tunneling, just focus on your movement more than the speed. If you want to master tunneling, go into a creative like this and go at half speed to practice. This helps you learn triple edits too. If you ever change inputs, you need to start from scratch and learn the basics all over again. I have a video from noob to pro creative drills that you should watch, since I don't have a lot of time to talk about this. Grind out each beginner drill till you could do it right. This is what I did when I was switching the controller. If for some reason you still don't utilize the clicks wall edit strat, then you really need to catch up. Learning how to box fight from one box away will save you in games. Never run over a build that's not yours unless you have to end game. People are always baiting these things. Stay calm with your head on screwed right and try and find a different route or replace the build to make it safe. Crack the Raider 464's peace control map, but under one condition. Do it where you're never exposed. My man Jivin TV has a video showing you how to approach every scenario without taking damage. Genius idea, my guy. This one is low-key a gamer tip. Your monitor should be head level. Lots of people have their monitor position where they're looking too down or looking too up at it. It should be perpendicular to your eyes. When you game for a long time, this is a must. If you don't believe me, come back in a few years and let me know how your neck feels. When you go to replace someone's wall, this is what you need to start doing every time. Hit the wall with your pickaxe before you land in front of their box. Every single pro does this. It gives the illusion of grabbing walls mad fast and increases your chances of actually getting it, since they only hear you and don't actually see you yet. It makes you believe that they're still on top sometimes. This is a very slept on tip. If you get stuck in your double edits, try this. I'm not sure if this is a personal thing, but what I did to fix this was I started lifting up my fingers off the edit button. Still pressing it fast as hell, but lifting up my fingers on both my mouse and my keyboard when editing seems to help me edit a little bit more consistent, because I can count better how many times I need to press it rather than just spamming it blatantly. This is something that you think would be dead by now, but it's not. I learned this one by watching Mr. Savage. When you're on keyboard with scroll wheel reset, you should still be practicing normal resets. Click your edit button, right click to reset, and then edit button again. If you're ever running back into old builds during late game or box fights, grab the wall with your edit button, then give your character enough time to get into the box, and then reset it manually. This is faster than trying to turn around and scroll wheel reset real quick. Throws your crosshair placement off. No one talks about that. It's slept on. But don't worry, Ken Bean's got you. Cool little high ground tip that lots of people switch to doing. When you're double ramping up, instead of completely flipping the stair the other way, just turn into the stair while rotating it 90 degrees, and you could do a cone 90 out of it. This is a faster way to high ground and helps you to not get peace controlled this hard. Crazy how people still do this. When your shields get knocked off, go heal up. It's a tragedy watching people die with heals and mats in their inventory. It's very good to know how to do Raiders' crazy edit courses, but don't feel like you must master them to be a god. Most pros don't even use maps like that, and Mr. Savage himself said that he sucks at doing them. His maps are the best out, but unless you got double or triple edit binds, focus time on the IQ and strategy side of Fortnite. I shouldn't have to say this, but when you're in creative, only use the shotguns that are in real games. The best way to get better at using the tac or charge is to go into realistic 1v1 maps, and you could literally select which shotty you want to use. Put some trust on your boy Ken Beans, grind this if you want to be good. In case you live under a rock, you can get bounties from the bots that walk around the map. Not all of them offer it, but if you're in a scrim, you might want to see what they have to offer, because they also give things like bouncers, which are key late game. And not only that, you could sometimes upgrade your guns from the NPCs. Instead of editing straight up like this, curve the direction you go up the ramp or curve the direction you're running on the floor to give the perception that you can edit faster. I recently been following my own tips from the last video about aim. Let me tell you, you're gonna notice a big difference in your aim if you just shoot targets in creative before you start playing. Literally spend 15 minutes going hard each time every day for a week or two, and your aim is gonna start feeling a lot better. That's not a joke. Every time you get on Fortnite, the goal is to find your flow state. This is the time period in which you feel the most warmed up, to the point where you feel like you can poop on anyone. Just like any other sport, if you want to do good, you need to be playing before the tournament or game starts, so that by the time you hit the first game, you body it. Write down the times in which you feel the most warm and pay attention to that. Maybe a certain warm-up routine that you do will put you in that flow state. Make sure you reload as you jump to never lose momentum. Every second matters in a scrim to position yourself correctly. If you use the charge shotty a lot and find yourself holding the charge, you need to know this tip. If you press the toggle pickaxe button two times mad fast, you could hold the shoot button the whole time and it still charges even after you switch back. You could use this to bait other people so hard.
Stop doing things that lead to a 50-50. You don't want to give the opponent any chance to try and shoot you back. Like one of the previous tips, this is one of the ways to do that.
If you want
to
master creative, learn the hardest side jump in the game. Master this and you will never, never lose high ground. If you find yourself high up, jump in a bush, haste
stack or garbage can and never take fall damage. Positioning yourself over one of these things during a build fight can save you if you run out of mats. If you're endgame and you're a solo and you don't have height or ulti low, constantly change layers so no one can track you. This is a pro strat that amateur pros don't use enough. If you play comp, try your best to learn how to be an IGL, support, and fragger player. Being able to know how each role works will help you do your own role even better. The meta in Fortnite at the moment is to make sure you take the least amount of damage in a fight using the least amount of mats. Easier said than done, but the reason why some of these pros are filthy is because no matter if they're on offense or defense, they barely get hit while box fighting. The most reliable way to take walls is the strat that 100T Arkrim uses. Position yourself next to the box on a wall and a stair, and then you can axe or shoot their wall to replace it, and then get piece control that way. This is what makes a pro. They give off this illusion that they can attack your box from a million different angles. During a 1v1, they literally never stop moving unless it's healing up. The next time you get in a fight, confuse the other person by snaking around other builds and running through edits. Just do whatever you can to hit heavy shotgun shots on the move. This makes you hard to track and makes the other person not want to take this fight. Tip 100. No cap. Start following me on Twitter and send me proof of using my code, because I'm going to start shouting out people at the end of the video like it's Jarian. A bonus tip for people that are struggling OD. The only way you're going to get on a good duo or a good trio is to learn how to play solos. Go into scrim discords or join someone's live stream where they host scrims and consistently win to prove to other people that you're worth the shot.
Holy shit. Damn.
I essentially just gave you 100 tips in the shortest amount of time that has ever been done on Fortnite. Do me just 3 simple things back and I will love you forever. Put code KenBeans in the item shop the next time you buy something from the store. Hit the sub button and drop a like on this vid for the one time. Let's aim for literally about 12 likes on this vid. If this video does well, I'm going to start handing out some V-Buck codes, so make sure you follow my socials down below in the description to stay up to date. If you want to learn more tips or ask me questions, I stream Fortnite Arenas all the time on my Twitch channel. Just the other day, I was hosting Zone Wars. That's the best place to learn more tips or ask me questions. Shout out to the peeps on screen using my code in the item shop right now. Thank you. Love y'all and hope y'all have a wonderful rest of your day or a good night. Deuces, everyone. Peace.